Most people treat their starter kits like toys. They follow the instructions, they plug in the wire, the LED blinks, and then they think they learn engineering. You didn't learn engineering. You followed a receipt. You painted by numbers. If I took away the instructions and told you to make that light to turn on when the room gets dark, could you do it? Or you would just stare at the wires? Real engineering isn't about following instructions. It's about mindset shift. I call it the engineering ladder. There are 5 levels, and most people get stuck on level 1 forever. But if you make it to the top, you become dangerous. Level 1 is blinky stage. You're just learning vocabulary. This is a button, this is a sensor, and this is a resistor. It's like learning individual notes on a piano. So basically trying to understand simple but important components and concepts. And level 2 is integration. This is where the notes become chords. You stop looking at parts as separate demos and start seeing a system. Here is a secret. Every electronics project is just 3 things. An input, a brain, and output. Real engineering is when you stop copying the demo code. You make the button code from lesson 3 and the motor code from lesson 8 and you smash them together to make a remote control door lock. You're writing your own sentences now. You aren't just reading from the book. Like everyone, I love modules. They're easy. They plug right in. But they're a trap. This sensor module costs $5. But if you look closely, the actual part that does the work costs 10 cents. Buying modules is like trying to water your lawn with bottled water. Yeah, it works, but it's a really expensive way to do it. And the worst part, it keeps you ignorant. So level 3 is a replace. You flip the board over, you read the part number on that tiny black chip, you download the datasheet. This is the engineering spellbook. It tells you exactly how the magic works. When you stop buying the pre-packaged bottled water and learn to use the raw components, you stop being a consumer of electronics. You become an owner of your circuits. You save money, you save space, and the most important, you gain control. Level 4 is the catalog. When you're a beginner, you build what the kit gives to you. But when you're an engineer, you build what you want. You stop searching for a generic Arduino sensor and start searching for the raw ingredients. Maybe you find a chip that costs 50 cents instead of $5. Now, if you're a beginner, this might be irrelevant to you, but by the time passing and, of course, you making progress on this field, you start thinking like an entrepreneur. So instead of using modules, you should know how to design that chip or whatever for that particular purpose. This is where the addiction starts. You don't just search, you discover. You find a part so cool that you invent a project just to use it. This is the difference between cooking a meal kit and walking into a grocery store with a blank check. The possibilities are endless. And finally, level 5. Perseverance, or as I call it, the hunt. Beginners panic when things break. They think they failed, but engineers expect things to break. In fact, if it works the first time, we get suspicious. Debugging is the ability to find what's the problem that holds your project from working properly. The problem could be a bug in the code, a short circuit, or it might be the power, or whatever. You hunt the problem down and you fix it. That feeling, breaking down the problem and fixing it, that is the highest high in engineering. If you can fix a system that you broke, you can build anything. If you want to learn more about debugging and the methods of debugging, you can watch this video on my channel. Most people never leave level 1. They stay in the tutorial loop forever, buying kit after kit, and never build anything original. But if you climb this ladder, if you integrate, replace, explore, and debug, you won't need a tutorial anymore. You won't need me anymore. You'll be able to take an idea from your head and hold it in your hands. And that makes you dangerous. Go make something.